think the themes we're seeing in this race are pretty similar to what we're seeing across the country. You know, Kotek is talking about the abortion issue in some of her advertising. I think Drazan, as a Republican in a blue-leaning state, in her own advertising is trying to maybe downplay her own party affiliation, which I think is probably smart. You've got Johnson, you know, essentially trying to attack both candidates. And, you know, you do see ads in this race that, you know, essentially attack ads against the other two candidates, which is kind of an interesting dynamic, because usually an attack ad is just an attack against, you know, against a single candidate. You know, inflation, crime, you know, those are big focuses for Republicans across the country. I think they continue to be a focus in this particular race. You know, abortion, Kotek is also trying to, I think, solidify Democrats and bring some Democrats who might support Johnson back into her fold by talking about the gun issue and talking about some of the votes that both Drazan and Johnson have cast that she, you know, basically says are pro-gun and not within the mainstream of where Oregonians are on the gun issue. One other, I just think, interesting aspect of this election is that not only do you have three major candidates in this race as opposed to just two, but all three of them are people who recently served in the state legislature. And so they all would have voted on some of the same issues over time. And so everyone's got a voting record. And so it's I think in some ways it's sort of this opposition research goldmine, as people on every side of the campaign sort of look for weaknesses in the other two candidates. And, you know, if you're one of the candidates and you feel like you've got a good position and the other two took a position on something that you think is unpopular, like that's a way that you could try to attack both of them. You know, so again, it sets up for just a kind of a fascinating situation where you really have three credible candidates, and they're all sort of intertwined in a way because of their service in the state legislature.